Welcome back to another video on solving radical equations. This one shows how to solve radical equations with two radicals. So here are the steps that we'll follow. Number one, we're going to put one radical on each side of the equal sign. Then we'll raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index, just like last time. However, now if one radical remains, we're going to have to isolate the remaining radical and raise both sides to the power of the index again, solve again, and then check our answers. So some of these problems are going to be fairly long, so let's go ahead and look at a couple examples. And this one shouldn't be too bad. Notice we have two square roots on one side, so we want to move one to the other side. Let's go ahead and add the square root of x minus 8. So if we add the square root of x minus 8 on both sides, that would give us the square root of 2x plus 3 must equal the square root of x minus 8. These are square roots, so the index is 2. That just reminds us we need to raise both sides of the equation to the power of 2. If we square the square root of 2x plus 3, we'll have 2x plus 3 must equal the square of the square root of x minus 8 will be x minus 8. In this case, we're fortunate because when we squared both sides, it eliminated both square roots. So we need to solve this for x and check our answer. So we'll subtract x on both sides. This will give us x plus 3 equals negative 8. We'll subtract 3 on both sides. X equals negative 11. Now, by the way, this is not looking very good because if we replace x with negative 11, we'll have 2 times negative 11, which is negative 22, plus 3. The square root of 18 is not real. Therefore, it can't be a solution. So this equation has no solution. So this is one of those extraneous solutions. Let's go ahead and try another. Again, we have two square roots, one on each side, so that's a good start. So we can go ahead and square both sides. Again, we can't square each term. We're squaring both sides of the equation. So when we square the left side, there's no shortcuts here. We have to multiply 3 plus square root x minus 6 times 3 plus square root x minus 6. And that'll equal the square root of x plus 9 all squared. Okay, so let's go ahead and multiply this out. Here we'll have 9 plus 3 square root x minus 6 plus another 3 square root x minus 6 plus, now the square root of x minus 6 times the square root of x minus 6, that'll give us x minus 6. And all of this must equal the square root of x plus 9 squared, that'll be x plus 9. Okay, let's see if we can simplify this. I see we have two constants. 9 minus 6, that would be 3. These two are like terms, that would be plus 6 square root x minus 6 plus x equals x plus 9. Next thing I notice is we have an x on both sides of the equation. If we subtract x on both sides, notice how the x terms are eliminated. Let's go ahead and rewrite this. So we want to isolate this square root, so we're going to subtract 3 on both sides. That'll give us 6 square root x minus 6 equals 6. Let's go ahead and take this over to the next screen. This is attached by multiplication, so now we'll divide both sides by 6. So we have the square root of x minus 6 equals 1. Finally, we've isolated the square root again, so now we'll square both sides again. On the left, we'll have x minus 6, and the right, we'll have 1. Add 6 to both sides. We have x equals 7 as our solution, but we should go back and check this, so let's do that. We're going to replace x with 7, so this won't be too bad. We'll have 3 plus the square root of 7 minus 6, that's the square root of 1, equals square root of 7 plus 9 would give us 16. This would be 3 plus 1 equals 4, and that checks. Okay, so you can see that some of these problems are going to be fairly time-consuming, so be very careful as you work through them, and at the end, you do want to make sure you go back and check your answer. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.